Now let's cover high-performance team dynamics as it relates to ACLS. The complexity of advanced resuscitation attempts requires a systematic and highly organized set of assessments and treatments to take place simultaneously in order to efficiently and effectively work as a team. In order for this to happen, it often requires an effective team of highly trained healthcare professionals to act in an organized, communicative, and effective manner. When this happens, the resuscitation rate increases while improving the chances of a successful patient outcome. Successful high-performance teams do not happen by chance. They're created. Not only do these teams have medical expertise and a high level of mastery of resuscitation skills, they're able to demonstrate effective treatments while utilizing effective communication. In a high-performance resuscitation team, there are no members that are better than another. Whether one team member is filling the role of team leader or a supportive team member, all of you are extremely important and play a special role in successful resuscitation efforts. So whether you're a team leader or a team member during a resuscitation attempt, all of you should understand not just your particular role, but the roles of the other resuscitation team members as well. This will help each team member anticipate what may be expected next and will help them perform their role with efficiency and communicate well as a vital member of a high-performance resuscitation team. Now, let's take a look at what each of these roles are and what requirements are for that role. The team leader is a role that requires a big picture mindset, and it has many different moving parts. The team leader keeps the resuscitation team organized and on track. They monitor the team's performance and accuracy while backing up team members when needed. They train and coach while facilitating understanding, and they focus on comprehensive patient care. You see, every symphony needs a conductor, and every high-performance resuscitation team needs a person to fill the role of team leader if the group is going to operate efficiently and effectively. It's the responsibility of the team leader to ensure that all team members are doing everything that should be done in the right way and at the right time. A team leader should be able to explain why the following is important, like pushing hard and fast in the center of the chest, ensuring complete chest recoil, minimizing interruptions in chest compressions, and avoiding excessive ventilation. The roles of team members must be carried out in a proficient manner based on the skills that those team members are authorized to do because of their scope of practice. It's vitally important that the resuscitation team understand and are clear about role assignments, they're prepared to fulfill their role and responsibilities, that they have working knowledge regarding algorithms, and that they've had sufficient practice in resuscitation skills, and they're committed to the success of the ACLS resuscitation. There are a total of 6 team member roles, and each of these roles are critical to the successful delivery of high-performance resuscitation techniques. You have the team leader, the person who is the compressor, the person who manages the airway. You have the individual overseeing AED, monitoring, and defibrillation, while we have an IV and an IO individual who also administers medications and delivers those medications appropriately all the time, while we have the last team member, which is the timer or recorder. Now let's break each of these roles out and speak briefly about what each role is expected to do. We talked a bit about the team leader in a vague overview kind of a way, but now we're going to speak more specifically about what they're supposed to do as part of the team. The team leader is the one who, when necessary, assigns the remaining needed roles to appropriate team members. They must make appropriate treatment decisions based on proper diagnosis and interpretation of the patient's signs and symptoms, including advanced assessment like 12-lead EKGs, laboratory reports, and the overall appearance of the patient. It's the team leader who has the responsibility to give feedback to the team, and they assume the roles of those who are not available or assignable. A compressor assesses the patient and performs CPR according to the latest and most effective recommendations and resuscitation guidelines. This person may alternate with the AED monitor defibrillator every 5 cycles or every 2 minutes. This can occur sooner if the compressor suffers from fatigue. Now, the person in charge of airway, they have to open the airway, but also maintain the airway. They work diligently to give proper bag mask ventilation, and they are also responsible for inserting both the basic and the advanced airway adjuncts as deemed appropriate. The next person is called the AED monitor defibrillator. This team member may be the person who brings and operates the AED monitor or defibrillator, and in certain cases, they may already find that that monitor defibrillator is already there, but they may still have to move it or slant it in such a way that the team leader, along with most of the other team members, are able to see it clearly. This person can change positions with the compressor every 5 cycles or approximately every 2 minutes, or at which time where the compressor is showing signs of fatigue and needs to change out. It's important that we realize that the CPR being delivered needs to be effective. That means compressions need to be deep enough and fast enough. Because if the BLS is not effective, it is going to then make the whole ACLS resuscitation ineffective as well. The next person is the IVIO medication person. The vascular access and medication role is an advanced cardiac life support role. It not only initiates vascular access using whatever technique required for successful and patent access, it also administers medications with accuracy when appropriate. The next person is called the timer recorder. The timer recorder team member records the time of interventions and medications and then announces when the next treatment is due. They record the frequency and duration of interruptions in compressions and communicates these to the team leader and the entire team.